kind of bursting at the seams here, so we're gonna let him loose. I have the pleasure of introducing, with his amazing band, the king of gospel and all bass at the moment, Andrew Gouche.
I hope I don't mess up. So listen, welcome you guys. I'm very honored that Bass Player Magazine thought enough of me to ask me to come do this. And also too, I want to share this with you guys. You guys are the first ones to know that I just found out that I'm going to be on the cover of Bass Player Magazine for the January issue. So, I'm very excited about that. Very, very excited. I'm honored to be here. This is Donald Hayes on saxophone. Any gospel record that you've heard that has got saxophone on it, that's that brother right there playing. Give it up for him, y'all. Come on, man. This is my brother Tracy Carter on keys. My brother Javon Day on keys. Some people, when you say their name, you have to say the one and only. The one and only Chris Coleman on drums. Chris just got off a tour with New Kids on the Block, but he's all those Israel Hawkins records live in South Africa. That's him playing Israel Houghton, you know what I'm saying? Israel Houghton. I'm a Friend of God and all those songs. That's that guy playing drums on all those things. And once again, Chris Coleman, and all the way from Paris, France, my boy on guitar, Stephen Lexman. So since we are the gospel guys, we're gonna start off with a song made famous by Walter Hawkins. It's called Thank You, Lord. Questions that anybody has, I'd love to answer them if I can. Does anybody have any questions? Yes, sir.
All right, what gave you the inspiration to detune your bass?
That's a funny story because I see a lot of young cats now, they tune down, and most of them weren't even alive when we started doing that. And the reason that we did was because back in the day, there was no such thing as a five-string bass. And most gospel songs are in A-flat, E-flat, B-flat, you know? And it just used to make me mad to have to go up here to play E-flat. And I told the story before, my good friend Joel Smith, great, great bass player, he tuned down to E-flat. He was already doing it, so I wanted to be lower than him, so I tuned down to D. And that's how it happened, you know. And then when five strings got, I'll never forget, I got my first five string bass, I think it was in 1980, might have been 85. And I had perfect pitch, and I'd been playing that way for so long. I started doing it in 82. And for me, I can't play a bass when it's tuned standard tuning, because if I look at it and I don't hear the note that my eyes see, and I can't play. If I ever go somewhere and sit in and play somebody else's bass, the first thing I have to do is tune it down. I can't even play it without tuning it down. So that's how that happened. It just, you know, even I was doing a lot of records, and I'll never forget the first time I played my five string was on an Edwin Hawkins Music and Arts Seminar record. And there was a break on the song, and and I played a low A. And the engineer was like, you can't do that, man. That note doesn't track, you know. And I'm like, can you hear that? It's tracking like crazy. So, you know, and that's just the way I play, you know, man. It's just, I'm comfortable doing it. You know, everybody has to do what's comfortable for them. But for me, tuning down is just the way to go. And it's just something about me here. So, you know, that's where they came from. Tuning down. Because there were no five string bass.
Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me.